Not me.
Well,
so,
it just happens to
I'll
be
leave that on the table.
Facts first. That room last night was grossly divided. I've never seen Nancy Pelosi's face like that. The president made some outreach to them, but he was focusing mostly on the Democrat, on the Republican side. How can he unify that room?
I think doing exactly what he did last night, and I'm going to be a little bit in disagreement with you. I think Nancy Pelosi looks like that all the time. I think she should smile a lot more often. I think the country would be better for it. She seems to kind of embody the bitterness that belongs in the Democrat Party right now. I think last night was a good step forward. Hopefully they can let go of some of that. And they have to make a big decision. They need to decide, Chris, do they love America more than they hate this president? And are they willing to put some of those differences aside, come together, and do what's right for this country?
The fundamental disagreement is on where's the hate, because Nancy Pelosi would argue, has argued on this set, that it is righteous indignation that you see coming from her, that the way last night the president identified the people who killed the children of those African-American couples that were there last night as illegal entrants, as minors. They took it as code for dreamers. That you're trying to villainize this group
Look,
of people.
There was no code. The president could not have been more clear. He has laid out exactly what he wants to see in an immigration reform plan. All of the things he has laid out are things that Democrats have supported. Bill Clinton got a standing ovation for using similar language in one of his State of the Union addresses by both Democrats and Republicans. Democrats have voted to end the visa lottery system. They support a pathway to citizenship. These are things that the president has given and laid out a good and solid compromise that, frankly, everybody should be excited about. Democrats and Republicans should both be celebrating. As the president said, everybody didn't get everything they wanted, but the country is getting what they need. And it's time for both Republicans and Democrats to come together and put some of that common sense solution forward.
Message versus messenger. Clinton, some of the language was a change. You know you have problems. You know you have to make the process better in terms of who gets into this country and also whom you decide to throw out. But the motivating ethos from Clinton, the idea was we are our diversity. The feeling is with this president, he sees diversity as a minus. Not one story last night. And by the way, the president did a good job articulating people's stories last night. And it's very powerful for the audience and for the media. But not one about a successful dreamer. Not one. Although he did say all Americans are dreamers, which, again, is not only not true, but I didn't understand the point of doing that.
Look, the president has committed to solving this problem. He has said he wants to find a solution, and he's laid one out. Democrats don't have a message. They simply are sitting on their hands and being angry instead of coming to the table to have real negotiations.
Because they believe it's a policy of exclusion. Because he has his
How
four
is
pillars.
It a policy of exclusion, Chris, when the president frankly went further than Barack Obama ever did as president? He has tripled the number of people that he has included
Fair
in
point.
This program. That is the opposite of exclusion. That is broadening the spectrum and taking it at